Bonjour, bonsoir Stacy, James, j'espère que vous allez bien. Voici le résumé du cours du jeudi 17 septembre. Qu'est-ce qu'on a fait la dernière fois? What did we do the last time? So we went through a lot of verbs like CER verbs and we just need to add a CCD with nous. GER verbs, we just need to keep the I in order to have the JON sound with nous. We went through the verbs like finir, second groupe, and we see the endings en IS, IS, IT, I double S, ONS, S, I double S, easy, and I double S, ENT. Dormir, third groupe. Je dors, tu dors, il dort. Nous dormons, vous dormez, ils dorment. And we're going to see that we have many, many, many groups. I mean, many endings, similar endings like that. Okay, so. Be careful of the pronunciation un. It's like number one, un, une. Alors, quel jour sommes-nous? Nous sommes le jeudi 17 septembre. Il est 7h08. Quel temps fait-il? C'est la nuit. It's a night. Il fait mauvais. It's a bad weather. Quel temps fait-il aujourd'hui? Quelle température fait-il aujourd'hui? Il fait chaud, il fait froid. Il fait beau, il fait frais, il fait doux, il fait mauvais, il fait du soleil, il fait 35 degrés, il fait du vent. Le verbe pleuvoir, for to rain, il pleut. Le verbe neiger, for to snow, il neige. Snowing. C'est nuageux, it's cloudy. C'est orageux ou c'est orageux, it's stormy, c'est humide, c'est lourd. In a sense, lourd means heavy. OK? I did click here. Lourd equals heavy. In a sense, it's like we feel like it's gonna rain. Hein? It's like prior to a storm, we feel like the air is really heavy, humid, hot, and it's gonna burst. Il y a du vent, that means there is wind, or we're gonna say it's windy basically. Il y a du brouillard, il y a une tempête, il y a une tempête de neige, il y a des nuages. So we are also using the verb faire, okay? Il fait faire for talking about the weather, but we can also use faire for other things. So, comme for instance, faire la cuisine. It's not to do the cooking, it's more like to cook, basically. Let's not forget that to the equals at the. Okay? So we have different options. O is masculine. À la is feminine. À l'apostrophe, it's because the noun starts with an H en a vowel. And the pronoun form is O with an X. So if I say je suis à l'hôtel, I am at the hotel. Je vais à l'hôtel, I'm going to the hotel. I'm using the same proposition here. Préférer, to prefer. Alors, so. Où sont les toilettes? So, in French, we say, where are the toilets? Okay, it's not rude. We can say, où sont les toilettes? Où sont les petits coins? Où est le petit coin? It's like the small corner, but it's a bit, it's more like for kids, you know. And, what else? Yeah. So next time, we're going to go through grammaire progressive, page 24, la page 24. And we did page 22, 23. Okay? So la page 23 is corrected. You have everything here. So I corrected some stuff here because there are like two mistakes. If I say good restaurants, actually in French, we're going to say de bons restaurants instead of des. Okay? It's a tiny bit more, it's not formal, it's just more, it's nicer for the French. For the French. Des personnes nouvelles, normally nouvelles should be before the noun, so I'm going to say de nouvelles personnes. We're going to see that in the future, de instead of des. So, c'est une chambre double, simple, trois étoiles, l'hôtel est complet, ils sont séparés, c'est une chambre simple, etc. Okay? So, concerning communication, well, you guys have the dialogue, but I want to. I don't know why I have this. to really get rid of this stuff. Hop. And faire une réservation is to make a reservation à l'hôtel. So we are noticing that it's at the, and it's an apostrophe. Le réceptionniste, le client. Hôtel du Moulin, bonjour. Bonjour, monsieur. Est-ce que vous avez une chambre libre? So, available, libre. Libre can be free. Une chambre pour deux personnes. Vous préférez, donc préférez, it's an ER verb. We know how to conjugate that. We deal with the same endings. E-E-S-E, O-N-S, E-Z-E-N-T. E-N-T. Okay. Une chambre avec salle de bain, so it's a bathroom, et WC, water closet, but before, a long time ago, they were separated, they were not in the bathroom, so we had to go outside, or, you know, it was considered to be a bit disgusting. I remember I had a great uncle, he had the restroom outside, not inside, so not really practical. So, le petit déjeuner est compris. Yeah, it's like included, basically, inclus. Je prends la chambre. I take the room. C'est à quel nom? What's the name? So, basically, if I want to translate, it's like, it's at what name? It's the name is under the name of, etc. Vous pouvez m'envoyer un fax. Can you send me a fax ou un courriel? I told you guys that I don't like really this name. It's more like official, bureaucratique, you know. I mean, it depends also how old you are. I prefer say email. I prefer email or mail. The French say also, vous pouvez m'envoyer un mail. It's confusing because in English, a mail is a snail mail, but not an email. So just be aware. De confirmation, OK, bien sûr, of course. Je le fais tout de suite. I do it right away. So this it is before the verb, okay? So that's basically a very easy dialogue, okay? Very easy. Next time we're going to talk about the train station. This one is not going to be that easy. It's the same kind of deal as a post office. Passez un bon week-end. On se voit donc mardi prochain. À très bientôt. Merci.